Hello and welcome to this edition of School Matters. I am your host, Bianca Rhodes. In today's program, we join 100 Strong and Achieve Minneapolis Career Fairs, where community partners are inspiring youth to prepare for great careers. And we'll enjoy highlights of Viva City performances at three different theaters. But first, let's go to a birthday party. This year is the 60th anniversary of the dedication of Lake Nokomis Community School, Winona Campus.
My name is Ella Applebaum. I'm in third grade here at Winona, and I'm also the president of the student council. And welcome to the 60th anniversary of Winona.
Staying warm at that time was more difficult for girls because no jeans or slacks could be worn to school. Raise your hand if you remember that.
This was actually written in 1956 when I was in first grade.
This chapter is called Go, Go.
Very well, and we do a lot of math and some things on history, and we have a lot of fun programs to learn about science.
Special community, and because of it, we have a very special school. So I'm glad to be here, and I welcome you all. I'm glad you're here too.
What do you want to be when you grow up? Does that sound like a familiar question? Today, there are many more choices than ever before. 100 Strong Who Care is an annual event that connects students with members of diverse business communities. At Nellie Stone Johnson Community School, volunteers visited with students and discussed higher education, career options, goal setting, and achievement.
Wanted them to focus a little bit on the things that get them to the point of a career.
I could be in business, I could join the FBI.
One, of course, for them to understand that school is a primary factor in them having a career. You just need to do the things you have to do, like get an education, to get the right career.
What I do right now is
I kind of shared my career path and how I got there, and I wanted to make sure that I focused on some of the obstacles that most people face as they try to decide what career they're going to go into. And so I wanted to kind of give them examples of what they can do now in order to propel themselves into a good position for high school and college. I think that it's important that people that are outside of the education industry, who are professionals, do invest time in going into schools and driving home the importance of education, because they are, you know, the future of our workforce. We need to foster a strong, quality workforce, and these are the types of opportunities that are going to encourage that.
No matter what profession you're in, whether it's an educator, an hourly waged employee, a salary employee, you know, you are a part of why this country ticks, and you're a part of why the kids in the future and how the kids in the future will tick. So letting them know there's possibilities and opportunities in the future is key, and you should be a part of that cycle. That's the only way our generations in the future will improve.
NPS welcomes the participation of volunteers, especially career professionals from communities of color, to serve as inspirational models for our students. For more information about participating in 100 Strong Who Care, contact the MPS Office of Equity and Diversity at 612-668-0018. Just as our younger students are looking for inspiration and role models, our high school students are getting closer to the reality of planning for life after high school. Each spring, Achieve Minneapolis hosts career fairs at Minneapolis Public High Schools to connect students with local professionals and help them learn about a wide range of exciting career opportunities. Twin Cities professionals from several industries talk with students one-on-one about their own personal career journeys, required training for their field, and great career and networking resources to help students take the next important steps forward.
Your income is going to be substantially higher if you actually go to college.
Achieve Minneapolis career fairs are held from March through May. Come share your career journey with Minneapolis students, our future global workforce. You have valuable experience and insights to share with students. To learn more, visit AchieveMinneapolis.org or call 612-455-1530. Viva City is a district-wide event showcasing the artistic achievement of Minneapolis public school students. This spring, our talented students thrilled audiences with powered pack performances at professional venues all around town. At the Cedar in South Minneapolis, the Ritz in Northeast Minneapolis, and the Capri in North Minneapolis. Lights, please.
Viva City is all about the arts in Minneapolis. It's a celebration of all our fine arts programming, which means it's visual art and performing arts. So we celebrate everything from theater and dance to the bands and choirs, as well as painting, sculpture, ceramics, you name it. It's all a part of the Viva City celebration. Viva City is about the kids and about the arts extending from what you see on stage when you go for a professional performance to where they start, when we start training the kids and working with the students, pre-K all the way through 12th grade. It's to be able to see firsthand what the growth is and see firsthand what the talent and ability is within our students. It's an opportunity to celebrate beyond just what they do in the classroom, but to let it be seen by their peers so that they can see each other, as well as can be celebrated by the administration, families, and the greater community. So the heart of Viva City is what I call art citizenry, in the sense that we are the arts performers of the city and we have a place within the arts community in Minneapolis. We celebrate all the theater artists at the Guthrie, with the Minnesota Opera, with the Mixed Blood Theater, all the theater groups. We have a place at the table within Minneapolis, within our programming within theater. Same thing goes with music. There's our fine jazz institutions and jazz groups. We like to have jazz represented within our nights because we are all part of the community and we are all part of the art citizens that make up Minneapolis and make us one of the best music and art cities in the country. And so the kids get that kind of an experience in the sense that they get to fully become a part of the community and recognize that they are a part of a theater community within the district. And we treat them as professionals in what they do. And I think that they walk away wanting to do it again because they get a taste of what it means to perform.
That's all for this month. Whether you are watching on Channel 15 or on the MPS website, thanks for tuning in. Until next time, I am your host, Bianca Rhodes.